Hey, what is up, guys? How are you guys doing today? It is me, Quinkin, and welcome to episode number 6 of my Atletico Madrid career mode. And I was reading the news, and I found this article that says I'm finding success without Diego Costa. And the truth is that we actually are. Chelsea took a lot of players from our squad. They took Diego Costa, Felipe Luis, and Thibaut Courtois. And to be honest, our squad is actually pretty strong without them. It would be stronger with them, but we did make a lot of money with them leaving our club. Moya and Oblak are actually great goalkeepers to replace Courtois. Sandro, the signing I made from Porto, he is so much like Felipe Luis, and he's such a great signing. He's having a great season so far. And Griezmann and Mandzukic were two very good signings. Mandzukic, in real life, he's really good, but in our career mode, I just can't find a spot for him in our team. But nonetheless, I don't think Mandzukic was such a great replacement for Diego Costa, but hopefully during this career mode, Mandzukic does get better. But I was taking a look at our schedule, and we were actually gonna have a tough week. We were gonna go up versus Roma in the Champions Cup, and then we were gonna have to face Valencia, who are in second place in La Liga. So these two games are the games that we're gonna play today, Roma and Valencia. Two very good teams. I'm surprised that Valencia is not in the Champions League, because they're always contenders to be in the Champions League in the top four. And over the past years, they've just been going down, getting rid of star players like David Villa, David Silva, Juan Mata. A lot of great players they've been getting rid of. But I had to change up my squad versus the game versus Roma, and I put Serchi on the right wing position, and I took out Griezmann and I put Mandzukic in. I wanted him to get an opportunity to play, so we put Mandzukic as the starting striker for today's game. We also moved Koke as a center mid, and I wanted to put Raul Garcia to play as a cam. So we took out Verratti and we put in Raul Garcia as the cam. That was going to be very good and crucial for today's game, because Roma are a very tactical team. Koke is a great dribbler, great passer, likes to go up front. Gabi is a player that likes to go up front sometimes, but he is the rock in the midfield. So hopefully that does work out for today's game. We also take out Alexandro and we put in Ansaldi, who hasn't been playing that much. And we also put in Fernando, who I'm loving in this career mode. And we took out Mario Suarez. Verratti's a little tired, so I put in Saul. And hopefully these young players do get to play in today's game. We also took out Alexandro from the bench and put in Jesus Gomez. And we also put Congolo in for Miranda. Miranda was tired, and I took him off the bench and I put in Jimenez instead. And Jan Oblak is going to be the starting goalkeeper for today's game. A lot of changes in today's game, but all my players are quality, great players that can play at any level. And in Europe, this is a squad that I'm going to be mainly using. But we are in first place. All of us drew our games in our group. And this is the squad that Roma was bringing up. A very good, solid 4-3-3. They got Totti, Gervinho. They got Pjanic, De Rossi, Muslera in goal. Their squad is very, very beefed up. But we were going to start things up here. A very good passer from Mandzukic to Serchi, and Serchi with the shot, and Roma were very good defensively. We were not going to open him up that easily, but Roma were very good. Gervinho here with a shot, and Oblak somehow saves that shot. Thank God Oblak was there with the save, and things were getting better and better with us, because our defense was so insane in today's game. Congolo and Godin were actually pretty damn good, but Roma were still attacking. They kept getting chances, and Totti really wanted to score in today's game. Pjanic was doing a lot for Roma. He was passing balls in spaces that our defenders couldn't get to, and Pjanic was overall the reason that we were having trouble in today's game. But going to the second half, we get a very good opportunity here with Serchi, but I had to change things up because Roma were dominating the hell out of us. So we took out Juanfran and put in Jesus Gomez. We took out Turan and put in Griezmann, and we took out Koke and put in Fernando. And the truth is that these changes only did a little in the game. We did make the substitutions, but we were still playing the same. Roma were still getting great opportunities. And Fernando, Jesus Christ, he had such a great opportunity to score. And that was the last opportunity that we had to score. And we do draw the game 0-0 versus Roma. And Roma, I have to say, are a very good side. And our group is very, very freaking hard. We are barely in second place. We've drawn both our games in the Champions League, and Sporting actually beat Bayern Leverkusen, and they have 4 points and they're leading our group, which is very surprising because Bayern Leverkusen is a very good side and Sporting is a great side too, but Bayern Leverkusen has more resources and much better players than Sporting, but Sporting for now are the group leaders with 4 points, and we are in second and third place with 2 points. So yes, Mandzukic did not score versus Roma, but it wasn't his fault. He tried his best, but Roma were too good. It was a very tight game where both teams were equal. So I decided to move Griezmann to the left, Sechi to the right, and I decided to take out Duran and put in Mandzukic for the game versus Valencia, who are in second place. And that is the switches I made to the starting 11. I did make some other changes in the bench. I put in Fernando for Mario Suarez once again, and Saul, I put him in for Ansaldi, and I wanted Alexandro to play the full 90 minutes, so I am going to put another midfielder on our bench. But the game versus Valencia was going to be one of the toughest tasks in my career, because Valencia are in second place, and we're already facing great teams early on in this season. But Valencia have a great side. They have Negredo up front. They got Diego Alves as the goalkeeper. So this was going to be a very, very good game to see how our squad is doing. So Valencia were the team that wanted to score so many goals. Negredo had so many damn chances, and he couldn't put it in back of the net. They get a corner here, and Jesus Christ, thank God we have two good goalkeepers, one in the league, one in the cup. Moya is there to save it, and he's been having a spectacular season. Here's Sechi going with the pace on the wings. He centers it into Koke, and Koke heads it straight to the goalkeeper. A great save from Diego Alves, but Negredo was doing so much. He dribbled us here. There's a shot from Javi Fuego. It just goes wide, and Valencia wanted to score. Our defense was all over the place towards the end of the first half, but going into the second half, I got tired of my team playing like crap. So I talked to him in the locker room, and Sergi puts a ball in for Mandzukic. And I told Mandzukic, if you don't score in today's game, I'm going to sell you in the January transfer window. And this is what he responds with me with. He scores a goal to bring us up 1-0 versus Valencia. And Valencia was a better side, and I decided to take out Verratti and put in Fernando. But as soon as I did that, we concede a goal. Oh my God. Moya is a great goalkeeper, but he keeps conceding goals. The goalie that is doing very well is Jano Black, and he is doing so well in our career. By putting Congolo aside, we wouldn't concede any more goals, and that is what happened. We come out of here with the draw versus Valencia. So we draw both games, the game versus Roma and the game versus Valencia. And this is how it left us in La Liga. We are actually in third place now with 15 points. And we are in third place because of goal difference. Barcelona also has 15 points. They have 5 wins, 1 loss. First place, 15 points. So La Liga is getting very tight, and things are getting very, very competitive, which is what I love about La Liga. It's very competitive. And, you know, it's not like the BPL where you have a lot of great teams, but these teams are very good and are very competitive, and they really do take points away from you. But this is the end of the video. If you guys did enjoy it, remember to leave a like and a comment down below. Please leave your comment down below. Tell me what you thought about today's video. And yeah, subscribe if you're new and you enjoy my content. I'm Quinkin, and I'll see you guys next time.